Hey everyone, this is Mukesh Udwani once again from learn-innovation.com. Today in this video, I will talk about how you can handle the calendar controls. Okay, so now if you talk about calendar controls, they are nowadays very frequently used, or I will say in each and every application you will find this calendar widgets. So when it comes to automating these widgets, it's very straightforward. You can apply multiple strategies here. So one of the strategies, like, you can just click on the calendar and click on the date. That is one of the easiest approach. Second approach could be you can click on the calendar, you will get all the dates, scrap all the dates and click on a specific date, okay. Third can be you can use JavaScript executor as well, and simply it will just type the date. Sometimes if you directly use Enkis, it might not work. So if you use JavaScript executor, it will forcefully inject that particular date into that particular date picker, okay. So multiple options you have. We will see two options today. One is, like, if you just click on date, calendar and date, and another one just scrap all the dates and click on a specific one. So for the same concept, we already discussed this video where we have discussed how to handle the auto suggestions and how we can automate them. So same approach, exactly same approach we are going to implement with calendar as well. So it will give you different perspective, but yeah, it's fun to automate calendar controls. So let's see how we can automate this.
Okay. So I already have discussed the same approach in our previous video. So let me quickly use the same approach for calendars as well. Let's create a Python file, and I will just give this file name as handle calendar. And now I simply need to start the browser and I need to work with the calendars. So let me show you two examples that I will be covering in this video. So first of all, as you can see, this is the moment I click on this date picker, I'm getting these options, right, where I can select the date. So right now it's 23, so it's selecting, or it's highlighting the default date. So this is one of the example that I will be taking. Second example that we will be taking, let's take some real site. Just a second. So maybe you can take some site, GoIBIBO, MakeMyTrip, or any other travel site, or any other site like hotel booking, where you will find these calendars, because these are very frequently use calendar widgets, right? So I will just search for GoIBIBO. It's GoIBIBO, yes. So just click on that GoIBIBO, and you can see we have a departure, then we have return, right? So how do we handle this? Actually, guys, process will remain same. It is just I will show you two different applications so that you will have a clear idea. So let's go ahead and let's start with the browser. So let me start with first of all WebDriver. So just type WebDriver and control space. Now we need to import this WebDriver. So just a second, WebDriver, and just make this W small. Come on. Yes. Okay. So we are importing now WebDriver. Then we want to work with Chrome, so we are importing Chrome. Now we are going to use WebDriver manager, right? So we discussed already. So we are using Chrome driver manager, and I will say dot install. So it will take care of the driver part. It will download and set the path, and we will be getting the driver here. Now I just need to open this application first. So I will just do a maximize. Then I will also set the implicitly wait in which is, okay, implicitly wait we can just set after this driver.get. So once it is done, now let's set the implicitly wait driver dot implicitly wait of hardly 10 seconds. Now this is the main task. First of all, I need to click here, then only this widget will open. So let's identify this. I will quickly check what are the locators we have. So you can see I have a ID, I have a class, so I can go with ID. Okay, so I will just first of all say find element by, and I will simply import this by class, it's ID here, and I will provide the ID, and finally I will say dot click. And then once this calendar widget will open, I will quickly see the approach will be, guys, first of all I will collect all the dates, and then I will search for a specific date and I will click. Second option, like, just click here and click on a specific date. Okay, so let's go in a first approach where I will simply select date 25th. So you can see this is 25th and this is coming under anchor tag, right? So I will just write a XPath that find an anchor link where I will simply write text equal to 25. So you can see one matching node found here. The moment I put mouse over, it is highlighting. So let's go ahead and just write find element by dot xpath, and I will just provide the xpath value and I will say dot click. This is one of the easiest option. So let's right click, run. Okay, so it's now downloading the latest driver, which is 87 at the time of this recording. And let's see, it will click first of all, and here you go. It selected day 25 because we just said we want to click on what day 25. Same approach will be applicable for GoIBIBO, the next application which I will be showing you. So let's see the second approach. So I will just comment this out. So in the second approach, I will write a generic XPath which will match all these dates, okay? And then we'll run a quick for loop. So if you see, this is the table, okay? So you can see this table has a class called UIDatePicker-calendar. So let's go ahead and let's find a table first of all. And this table have a class. So this is one calendar which is getting highlighted, right? Now, as we discussed in the XPath video, so now I just want to use only the hyperlinks, right? So I will just say double slash A, and you can see I'm getting 30 matching nodes, which is equal to all the dates that we have here. Perfect. So let's do one thing, go back to our PyCharm, and this time I will be using find elements. Okay. So we discussed earlier that if I want to work with single web element, I will use find element. But if I have to work with multiple web elements, I need to go with find elements. Again, I will be using by class, and the one which we are using is XPath, and this is the XPath. And as we know, once we deal with multiple web elements, once we use find elements, we always get a list, right? So I will just say this is the dates. So if you just see the type of the dates, it will be always a list. So let me do one thing. Now let me just do an iteration. I will run a for loop, and here I will store all the date one by one. So I will make this as date in dates. So it will just get the first element, it will store into date, which is again a web element, and then we will continue. So I will just mention date. This is actually web element, guys. So what I will do, I will say get attribute, or maybe we can directly do a text. So it will capture the text and we will get the data. So I will just say here data. Now I will just do a quick if condition. If data dot, oh sorry, if data equal to, let's say 25. Okay, then click here, right? So now where we need to click? We need to click on the web element. So just click on this date. Okay, so you can see, guys, date, dates, data, you might get confused. So let's do one thing. I will say make it all dates. So it should look little different. This is individual date, and I will say this, let's make it date element. Okay, and this, let's make it date, proper date. So this date we are checking, if this date equal to 25, then we need to click, right? Now this click is a method of web element. So what is our web element? This is our web element, right? This is list of web elements. One by one, it will return all the dates. So we will just click here and we'll say click on a specific date. That's all. Very easy approach. And once we are done, we will quickly break this, else it will keep on running this for loop. And let's do one more thing. Let's print the date also, so that we'll get to know how it is iterating. Okay. So very easy one. Find all the dates. Then we are iterating, capturing the test, printing, and we are checking one by one. So once it will reach to this condition where date is equal to 25, it will click on that particular web element and it will break. So when I simply run, you will see same output. It is just this time we are getting all the dates and then we are clicking, and here you go. Very easy, guys. It is just you need to sit and try, and you can see we are getting all the dates right with the help of this for loop. Correct? Now, if you just notice, after 25th, since we are using break, it is not running. Otherwise, it could have given us the date 26, 27, and so on. Since we are using break, it is stopping that loop here. Yeah, so that's a very easy one. So let me run the same program for Go IBBO. So it is just we need to change few locators. So I'll make it handle calendar 2. And this one. So for Go IBBO, let me just take this URL and let me quickly update here. Fine. Now, first of all, we need to click here, then only this calendar widget will open. So right click and click on inspect. So as you can see, this is we got a very good placeholder called departure. So if you don't want to use this placeholder, you can also see we have a departure calendar. So if you identify this one, you will find it's a return calendar. So thanks to Go IBBO for maintaining such a beautiful IDs so that automation should not be a challenge for their team. So you can see we got this, right? So let's do one thing. Let's take this ID, and to be little secure or to be little on safe side, I will just take departure where ID contain departure. So let's do one thing. Let's write a input where it contains ID. Okay. And I will only check this departure. And you can see one of one is matching. So now this looks little good. I can see we're using find a element where XPath is input tag which contains ID only departure. Okay, so we will click on this and then this widget will open. So let's do one thing. Let's identify this calendar first of all. So you can see this is a div tag, and again we got it's a day picker, right? So if I expand this, I have this is again day picker month. When I expand this, you can see I got all the weekdays which is getting highlighted. Then finally I got the body. So maybe we can directly come back here, okay, and we can just check find a div tag which contains class day picker body. And you can see one of one means now this is getting highlighted. Perfect. Now if you go little further, you can see 5 days, right? And you just notice on the UI, this is one row, second row, third row, so fourth and so on. If I expand these again, I have these divs, right? Div 1, div 2 and so on. But if you expand a little further, you will also find a one more div tag which is actually having the real value, right? Which is 1. So if you see this also have a dedicated class called calDev, which is calendar date. So let me write one more condition that find a div tag which contains or which has the class equal to calendar date. And here we go. It is matching 30 different dates, right? Now let me store this into a notepad because I want to show you one more thing. That what if I simply remove everything? I will only maintain this part, that find a div tag which contains class equal to cal date, which is calendar date. Still we are able to get all the 30 dates as you can see here. So whether you go with this XPath or this XPath, output will remain same. So let me use this one because it's giving me the same result, plus we don't have to worry about one additional tag. So let's use this one. Let's go back here. Same example, guys, and I'm just changing this XPath. Okay, so if you don't want to go with this approach, this is also one of the good approach that we discussed, right? You can find a date directly. In our case, it's a div tag. So let's do one thing. Let's remove this and only try first this approach where we will just check Okay, I got an idea here. Just a second, guys. First, we will try this dev tag. Okay, so let me just get the older code. And here I will just first of all get this right. So here for departure calendar, I'm selecting a date 25. And for the next calendar, we will use a second approach. So here, if you see, we got the same ID. So let me use again that find a input tag, and let's find this element which contains ID equal to return calendar. I will simply remove this calendar, and I have only return. If you just notice, guys, we got two matching node here. One is hidden, as you can see here, right? So don't worry about this. Only the first one is anyways visible. So let's copy this. So this is for departure. Once it will select the date, now I will say driver.findElement by .xpath, and here I will simply click on return calendar. Then again we will get all the dates, right? Which is this one. This anyways we have selected right away. So again, rest everything is same. It will find all the dates. It will store into this date elements. Will capture the date. Will print and will click once date is equal to 25. So let's do one thing. This should be 25. Let's keep this as 28. And let's see how it works. So right click, run, and it should select two different dates. One from departure. One from the return. Okay, perfect. So you can see the first part selected 25th and the second part selected 28th. So quite easy. And since after this we are using a break, so it is printing all the dates till 28. After that it is not printing. So very easy. So just give a try, guys. Please practice, because practice is really very important. If you don't try this code, you might not be able to understand. Right, so please try, and if you like this video, make sure you subscribe to this channel, share with your friends, and in case if you find any other issue, let me know in the comment section. Thank you so much, guys. Have a nice day. Bye bye.